Hello and welcome to part 8 of the first of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. In this part you'll learn how to create your own modules in an Oracle Jet application. Oracle Jet applications are inherently modular. Though it is possible to create non-modular Jet applications, doing so would mean missing out on one of the key advantages of Jet. As soon as you have used one of the Jet templates to set up your application, as shown in the previous parts of this course, you have an application infrastructure that has all the hooks and handholds you need for creating modules. What is a module? How large should a module be? What should a module represent in your application? These are typical questions you should be asking yourself right now. When you think back to the parts of this course dealing with require and with knockout, you'll have a very good idea about what a Jet module looks like. An Oracle Jet module has its business logic expressed in JavaScript and its view expressed in HTML. The business logic is defined within a define block, as provided by require. The view is connected to the business logic via two-way data bindings provided by knockout. Typically, a module represents a new section within your application, which provides a new feature to the user. Let's now create our first Oracle Jet module. Using the Oracle Jet application we set up in the previous tasks, that is, the applications defined by means of the Oracle Jet command line interface, we'll define a new module in it and integrate it into the application. Here we see the application that we've been looking at so far in this course. Take note of the navigation list along the top of the application. When a different item in the navigation list is clicked, different content is loaded. The content that is loaded comes from a module that is associated with the item in the navigation list. What we are now going to create is a new Oracle Jet module that will be loaded when a new item in the navigation list is clicked. Each module in an Oracle Jet application is defined by default by a JavaScript file in the source.js view models folder and an HTML file in the source.js views folder. The HTML file and the JavaScript file have, by default, the same name. So, for example, about HTML and about JS. Customers HTML and customer JS. A simple way, therefore, to create a new Oracle Jet module is to copy one of the existing JavaScript files and one of the existing HTML files and to rename them according to your requirements. Another way is in NetBeans to go to New and Other, and then at the end of the HTML5 JavaScript category in the New File dialog, you will see that there are two templates, the first of which we will be using here. This is called Empty Jet Module. It will create a simple Oracle Jet module, putting the JavaScript file and the HTML file in the right location. There is also the Knockout Jet Module template, which creates a slightly more complex Oracle Jet module with more detailed content. We start by specifying exactly where we would like our Oracle Jet module to be created. In source.js view models and in source.js views. We provide a name for our module, for example, employees. We imagine that we want to create a new Oracle Jet module to manage the employees in our application, and we click finish. We now have employees HTML and employees JS. Employees JS is a simple define block with some placeholder content, a starting point for your own logic, as well as an employees HTML file with a simple H1, which you can expand with your own content. Now that we have our employees module, how do we hook it into our application? A file that we have not looked at yet is the AppController.js file. This is a file that by default provides the global settings for usage throughout our application. The file is loaded into the main.js file in the require block. In main.js, take a look at the require block and notice that AppController is loaded here and that it is referenced. As pointed out in the previous part in this course, the order in which parameters are specified in the function callback should match the order in which the related item is loaded into the require block. The third item is app controller, and therefore the third item in the function callback is our app controller. This is where the global properties are loaded into the application at startup. And here are all the global properties that are provided by default by the template that you used to set up the application. Notice that there is here a section called router, which we're going to look at in more detail later. And there is also a section here called nav data. Intuitively, we see dashboard, incidents, customers, and about, which matches the names of the different Oracle Jet modules provided by default. And similarly, in nav data, there is dashboard, incidents, customers, and about. Without any further detailed knowledge about what all of this means, we can already copy and paste and change customers here to employees and specify as label employees. And secondly, we can copy our nav data and paste it. And again, change the references to match our employee requirements. Having done that, we have updated our navigation setup. We have updated our router setup. We save, and then we go back into the browser. In the browser, we see that we now have, in addition to the modules we had at the start, an additional module for managing our employees. It has been integrated very easily into our application. And in the same way, we can remove modules from our application. For example, to remove customers, we simply delete customers from the router setup. Similarly, we remove it from the navigation data. We save the file, go back into the browser, and we notice that we don't have a customers module anymore. In short, creating new Oracle Jet modules is easy, and integrating them into the application is easy as well. You have now seen how to add new modules to your application. Whichever approach you take, be aware of the benefits of Oracle Jet's integrated support for modularity, and structure your application so that you can make use of these benefits yourself. For your homework, use the steps you have learned in this part of the lesson to create your own Jet modules and add them to the applications that you've been creating so far.